The first things that I started to learn about technology was that it has this great ability to shape people's lives in either a really positive way, sometimes in a negative way. And I really wanted to be on the side that perpetuates technology for use in a very good way. And that was something that became really important to me. I'm Amanda Molinari. I'm an IT project manager with Utah Education and Telehealth Network. Being in IT, I also, like, it was rarely noticed out in California anyways, that I was often the only woman on a staff. And, you know, and it was really, it wasn't anything that I took a lot of note of, but I, somebody that I looked up to a lot that also had very similar experiences with that was my grandma. And she was a scientist. She was a molecular biologist at a time where women weren't really pushed to be getting into the sciences, and they were actually turned away from doing that. I feel like I really related to that, and I wanted to be just like her. I was actually in school for the fine arts, and I got the opportunity to work for a regional ISP out in California through knowing some people, and they said, you know, would you like to work with us? And I absolutely just fell in love with it. And as I progressed, they gave me more responsibility. So I've gotten to wear a lot of multiple hats, and that's how most of my jobs have been. I feel like project management now in my career is a culmination of all these different experiences that I've had, and I get to draw on all of those. Before I even moved to Utah, the only thing that I read about was that the outdoors are really big out here. And that's all I needed to know. And that's all that was it. And I said, I will be fine there. I'll go backpacking, and I often take my dogs and just let them, like, just be free. I mean, they're running and they're having a blast. They're playing in the snow and everything else, and they're just my little family. As a project manager, I oversee a variety of projects, ranging from circuit turnups to working on Eduroam, fiber documentation, and advocacy work. Eduroam, at the school districts, teachers, faculty, and staff, they're able to travel to different sites, whether they're doing training or filling in for another role or going to conferences or anything like that. And they're literally just opening up their device and they're on Wi-Fi. So easy, so quick for them. Another project that I love, and they're actually a grouping of a lot of projects, are circuit turnups. And that's really near and dear to my heart. That's almost where I started in IT. My role is really to align our goals, which is getting that circuit turned up in a timely manner. You know, those are actually projects that have a lot of deadlines and that sort of thing. And I also work with a lot of UEN groups. So I'm working with our network operations center, network engineer, field engineers, a lot of moving parts to these circuit turnups, and it's a blast seeing them finally go to completion and knowing that they've got a new service there and one that they're happy with. Art and being in my studio is sort of my recharge kind of space. I do paintings, I do a lot of sewing, I do quilting, I make stuffed animals. I've actually started to make these quilted postcards, and this actually started during the pandemic. And I had heard about this group or organization called Post Crossing, and I looked into it, and it's basically, you know, anonymous, and you send postcards all over the world, and you get postcards all over the world. And I've started making these quilted postcards, and it's taking my love of quilting and my love of post crossing and kind of mashing them together. And I do that a lot in life anyways. If I'm learning something over here and I'm learning something over here, I might mash them together and see how they work. And that creative process is often used to, like, solve problems. Or, you know, if I'm faced with something on a project and I realize, and this happened recently, is that sometimes a project needs a little time and space, like a painting does. You know, I might be working on a painting and then I say, gosh, I'm not really getting anywhere with it. I need to just give it some space and let it sit for a little bit. And I've started to notice that with certain projects that don't have a hard deadline, and I could give it a little bit more space, and I could, you know, create a balance, and then you know, maybe something better comes along as an opportunity in that project to solve a problem. When I first started at UEN, I had kind of thought that I might be here for maybe a couple years and kind of move on. And I fell in love with what we do at UEN. And I'm starting to daydream about my projects and my life here in Utah and with UETN. Future wise, like 3 years down the road, what are my projects going to be like and that sort of thing. And so I see a much bigger future here. And I think that part of that is really that my idealistic side of me that I had really wanted to do good with technology, I feel like is being fulfilled here.